Kiroche Breweries last week unveiled a 500 million shilling spirits bottling line as it positions itself to capture a major stake of the local alcoholic drinks market with a target market of 30%. But the brewer, which is the first major indigenous-owned brewery, is worried that the short compliance period set for manufacturers are hampering more investment in the country due to the high cost of procuring industrial equipment as well as the long period taken to install the equipment.
Every time that one invests, it's always good that the government can give a guarantee that whatever is invested in, it is something that will keep on going.
Part of becoming a middle-income country means moving from unskilled manpower to skilled manpower, and Kenya is looking to encourage investment, especially in industry, to ensure more and more Kenyans are employed in such industries.
It has given an opportunity to high-skilled labor employees that have just graduated from our universities.
The new bottling line, which requires the application of skilled manpower, has the capacity to bottle over 10,000 bottles an hour and can easily be adopted to various packaging specifications. Kiroche seems to have learned its lesson from a change in bottling specifications under the now famous Motudo laws. The regulations, which have seen Kiroche invest over half a billion shillings, change the packaging rules for spirits, eliminating the use of plastic containers in favor of glass to make it harder for brewers of illicit brew to package and retail their products. For Citizen Business, I'm Henry Gedhaiga in Naivasha, Nakuru County.